Welcome back, everybody, once again to Discordancy, a CTM map from the Project CTM guys. So I derped last episode and didn't even realize that the monument is right here at intersection 1. I can be so very unaware sometimes and do some really silly things. In fact, and this explains why you haven't seen an episode from me in a couple days on this map. If you want to see some real derpiness from me, you should definitely watch my first attempt, and keep in mind it is my first attempt at speedrunning, blind speedrunning a map. I just do some really silly things. I kind of walked by this place already, which is why those spawners were already active. I think I'm going to try to preserve the spawners in case I ever need a gunpowder farm. But yeah, I do some really silly things in that map. For example, at the very beginning, you have to do this kind of parkour jumping thing. And I totally forget that in Minecraft you can break blocks. Yes, you can break blocks in Minecraft. Imagine that. A Smite 1 Sharpness 2 sword. Don't know if I really need that. The potion is much needed, though. I do appreciate that. And we have gravel and lots of coal and whatnot. So this little cave will definitely come in handy. I have already kind of explored the monument and looked around for secrets and whatnot. We have Pelican's destroyed boat. Nothing in the water or the waterfalls as far as I can tell. But there are a few secrets here and there that I waited to check out until I was recording so that you guys could see them with me. I believe that there's like a little graveyard or something, a little grave up here that we definitely want to check out. Here we have Shrine of the Fallen Hero. May history forever remember his deeds. Okay, who is this? Rock. I wonder if that's a reference to Rock and Roll, another YouTuber who does a lot of CTM maps. I think the name is Rock and Roll for Life. And there was another thing right over here. We have Resting Place of the Righteous. But yeah, in that speedrun, I made so many mistakes. Like, I just, yeah. You really gotta watch it and just shake your head the entire time. And just be like, what are you doing, TJ? What are you doing? Oh, this is interesting. I'm pretty sure those two are from Savage Realm, aren't they? And then that's from Chimerian Memories, which is another map that I do plan on playing eventually. And a sponge, okay. That doesn't have the little plus to health, though. That would be nice if it actually did have that. Hey, that has a speed boost and some attack on it, even. I don't know. I have that wooden sword that has knockback and smite on it. That was a terrible jump. Terrible jump. Yeah. So I've explored the monument. We do need to head back to the first area. I was mistaken. I got confused. I was thinking we're still collecting wool, which we are not. We are collecting records. And so I think last episode I was saying something along the lines of that first area having two wool, the white and yellow wool, but that would not make any sense whatsoever. Because, first of all, the progression for the wools is always white to orange, so it wouldn't make sense in that case, but it also wouldn't make sense because we're not collecting wool, we're collecting frickin' music discs. Which does mean fewer objectives, and I kinda like it, because whenever you get one, you get to place it, and it plays music, which is usually some pretty decent music. This is probably the worst one, though. It's really terrible. Alright, let's go ahead and check out the rest of the monument. Honestly, there's not much here, not much in the way of secrets. I did change these little waterfalls for a couple of reasons. One, I think it looks better aesthetically. But two, it also makes it much easier to kind of hop over here. Or not. Another opportunity to laugh at TJ. There you go. But I did it so I could hop over here and check out for secrets. I did check behind there, but as far as I know, there's nothing there. Let's see if we can do this. We gotta get up. There we go. Little teleporter room, and we will use that to teleport back to intersection 1. That guy freaked me out the first time that I saw him. I already knocked down this painting, and then I put it back up, just so you guys could get the same effect that I had. There's a mushroom back here named Suggestive Susan. So I was somewhat mistaken. No, I don't like that. I was thinking, hey, that looks kind of cool, actually. I was thinking that this was like the next big project from the Project CTM guys, but I guess it's more of a side project where they just, you know, a bunch of friends kind of got on a server and all had fun building it. We have kind of crops and tree farms and food and whatnot. And so they still have Titan's Revolt, which is another, I think it's going to be a much larger map and, you know, probably just more, I don't want to say polished, but it's the one that they've been working on for a long, long time. Here we have the Prismarine Monument. And I will say, I don't think I ever checked behind it, but I will say that I found a fourth piece of prismarine. Hey, look at this, you guys. Prismarine shard number 63. Okay, we'll leave that one there. We will leave that one there. But I found it said bonus prismarine shard number 1. And so we can actually complete that one. But I would rather find the original 4 and not have to rely on a bonus one in order to complete that monument. I think that's pretty much it. I will say I don't care much for the monument. I mean, it's aesthetically it's nice and it has everything you need. But gosh, it's just the traveling time. I know the teleporters help out a little bit. But the traveling time is just it's so massive and it takes so much time. I'd rather just have like the monument and then, I don't know, maybe a little bit of area to build in, but let the player customize it. And not just throw everything at them. I know that's kind of become the conventional way to do it. Is that supposed to be like that? That seems a little off to me. But I know often players will expect for there to be just like a fully fleshed out, you know, kind of base with everything already in it. But I'm not a big fan of that. And in terms of the travel time that it takes, I think it's a little inconvenient. But that's just me. Let's go ahead and teleport to intersection 1. And I have done this before. I will show you guys where I found the hidden... Oh gosh, I hate navigating this place. There's too many staircases. Where I found the additional... Oop, lag spike. Prismarine shard, the extra one. It was right there. I was down at the bottom and I saw it. And what else? We need to head this direction. I think I need to grab that guy. Let's go ahead and put that guy up and make sure we have our health potion on our bar. I think we want it right there. I would love to get a brewing thing so that we could extend that, or I mean make it stronger, but currently I don't think we have that ability. And yeah, I think we're pretty much ready to go. So I built a little grinder. I built the grinder because I needed arrows, and then pretty much immediately after building it, I found the monument, and I found a bunch of arrows in the monument, so this was not really needed. But I have fun doing this, and it's a really basic one. Just dug down, they fall, I go down and kill them, I get levels, and I get arrows, and that's how I was able to combine that and get projectile protection 4, and all that lovely stuff. So anyways, I will see you guys over at, I don't know, whatever it's, there's like something A, and then we're going to go to B now. I forget the name of it. What is it? Okay, yeah, Mineshaft A and Mineshaft B. I did kind of poke my head in here. I think I was trying to get levels or something. Let's go ahead and, hey. Gosh, these guys are pretty tough, man. In fact, all the custom mobs so far have been rather challenging. Feel a little tongue-tied today. Tongue-tied, things are not working for me as far as the language goes, as far as the speaking goes. What do we have here? We got lots of vines, which I hate. I was thinking about trying to burn them down, but I don't think fire spread is on. So that won't really be effective. It'll just hurt me, if anything. Do I want... I guess, yeah, I think we want this for now. I don't know. Alright, back up. Light on fire, zombies. Actually, don't light on fire, because then you're going to light me on fire, and that would not be very much fun. Go away, skeleton. Thank you. Fly away. Fly far, far away. And let's try to run and jump and jump and run. Go away, Mr. Spider. We do not like your kind around here. Light it up. Whee! Oh, gosh. Okay, let's head in this direction, then. Oh, no, another creeper. Oh, okay. That was fun. I like that. That was enjoyable. And we got some coal, too. And a new pick, as well. Let me just hang out and recover some health real quick. And then we'll get moving again. I'm also on the lookout for another helmet, just to repair those. It was a mistake to put thorns on there, but whatever. Whatever I say. Come to me, my creeper friends. Alright, I think we've recovered enough health. Oh, of course, you guys. Well, that worked out for me, I think. Worked out perfectly for me, and we have junk. Okay, that's interesting. Junk. I guess we should probably exchange those. Huh? I want to keep the projectile protection 4, though. That's some powerful, powerful stuff right there. And go away! Go away! Go away! I think I saw something else. Nope. Okay, I think we're good. Eat the potato. Eat the potato. Oh my gosh, you guys, my wife made these mashed potatoes last night that were just freaking amazing. I absolutely enjoyed them so very much, and lots of creepers. In one sense, the vines hurt me in terms of movement, but they also help me because of things like visibility and whatnot. Oh my gosh, getting a little nervous here. Getting a little nervous indeed. Just hop around everything and everyone, light it all up, and use the vines to your benefit if possible. Alright, creeper spawner up above right there. Let's see if we can hop up this way. Okay, whoa, okay, I thought something was behind me. Nothing was behind me, though. We have lava. And it looked like this was the direction, no? Okay, no, there is a shard at the very least. So I guess this is the final shard, then? Oh gosh, didn't mean to do that. And I heard one more spawn. We'll just light it up, grab the final prismarine shard, which means we can complete that part of the monument. I'm not sure if it gives you anything special to beat it, or if it's just entirely a bonus objective or what. But we will certainly try our best to find all of those guys. Boom, explosion. Alright, and is that it then? It kind of looks like we're supposed to continue on in this direction. Hello there, guy. Or not. Okay, there is some... a chest down here at the very least, along with some bad guys, some baddies. Go away, bad guys. And I'm hoping to get to the next area this episode as well, if possible. Okay, they're spawning from up above there. Good to know. Let's just get down in here and try to do some damage. Very nice, took them out. And he's dancing, so he's not gonna come after me. And make sure that that gets lit up really well. I'm not sure where that zombie came from. Alright, we have some leather. That's actually really helpful for these boots that I have. Some more arrows, and don't need the wheat. Oh gosh, okay, okay, okay. I see ya. I hear ya. I hear ya. I hear ya. Do not want to use this potion. Not quite, at least. Just get me up and out of here, please. Get me up and out of here. Hide. Eat the potato. You know, I have to kind of check down here to see if there's anything, right? Peek my head out. There's another part in the speedrunning where I'm like, hey, can you climb on vines? And it's like, I've done this before. I've done it before. I don't know, it was so early, and I think the pressure to perform well was hurting me. Oh, I think we could just go right over there to finish this area. In fact, let's try to do that. Anything up here? Does not appear so. Alright. That was kind of strange. Anybody else see the particle effects coming out of the lava? Almost as though something is spawning in there and then dying? That was odd. Something may have fallen down in the lava that I didn't see. I don't know. A do's and not to know. Alright, I guess we're pretty much done then. It was just for that shard. Unless you guys see something else. But I think we're good, and it's good thing too, because these boots are just about dead. Fire spread off! Dang it! Alright, so I'll see you guys back at intersection 1 then. Would you look at that, you guys? I was so focused on climbing all the waterfalls that I didn't bother to look down before. And we have something down here. From the looks of it. Interesting. Okay. Oh no, I didn't want to let the water in. Oh well. Actually, the water... Okay, now there the water goes. We have a holy steak. Okay. That seems kind of odd. I'm gonna drown. Yeah, that seems kind of strange. I don't know. I mean, bait of arthropods. Yeah, I don't know. That's weird. Very strange. Alright, so I found this, apparently, at some point. And it has protection, too. Which I think might benefit me a little more. But I need 17 levels in order to repair it. So I'm going to go ahead and earn up some levels to be able to do that. And then we're going to head, I believe, the next place to head to is this green record area. So yes, white gold record, green record, orange record. These are not wools. You got to get the image of wools out of your mind, guy. Stop thinking about it, dang it. But yeah, I'm gonna get some levels, and I will be right back with you guys. All right, just to test and see if we do get anything for this, I decided to go ahead and try to place the first block. And apparently no. Okay, I don't even get a little like message like, "Oh, okay, you got the first thing. Fantastic." That's all right. We have to keep in mind, I'm gonna have to remind everybody each and every episode that this is in beta. And I have to say, for it being in beta, this is pretty amazing. Pretty amazing indeed. Oh, I'm trying to teleport to the first intersection. That's what we want to do. Let's go ahead and get that sword on the bar, please. And boop, 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 boop. Teleport to intersection one. So yes, this is the gear I'm working with now. I never did get another helmet. I almost walked off that direction. I get so confused in this room, you guys. I know that's probably the intended effect, but I really, really do get confused. Like, part of me wonders if I'm supposed to be bringing one of these with me. Maybe there's going to be a lot of spiders in this area. It is a grove, right? Grove of Starlight. I wonder if the titles ever clue you into what's coming. I mean, I know sometimes they do. Did I just throw that out? Oh no, those are bowls. I don't need the bowls. Be gone, bowls. We do not need you. I'm gonna bring it along just in case. I like having this knockback three sword. It's very nice as a defensive weapon. But yeah, I guess we just head into the next area. And honestly, I got a little peek at it, and it seemed very straightforward. So I think, I don't know. I'm a little skeptical at this point. I feel like we can just run straight through it. So that's what we're gonna do. And that or Ender Pearls. I don't know. If I'm running, I guess Ender Pearls just in case. And yeah, let's just go for it, shall we? Whee! Thank you for the boost there, guy. I hear potions. Interesting. Lots of creepers as well. Oh gosh. Wither potions. Something. Okay. So I think something is hitting me. Oh my gosh. There are like super duper fast skeletons, you guys. We need to get out of here, please. Please, please, please. Oh, she got me. She got me. She got me. She got me good. Let's hop over here, please. Please, no skeletons. Let's box ourselves off real quick. I thought. Oh, okay. That could have been very bad. Area complete, shadow of Pluto. What the heck? That's kind of strange. Kind of strange indeed. Will you freaking cut it out, Mr. Poison? Go away. The spider is still coming for me. I can hear it. I can hear it. Light. There's a chest right down there. Whoa, okay. I'm still trying to figure out what the heck is going on. Yeah. I don't know why it gave me the area complete thing again. That was kind of strange. Are there not spawn? I could have sworn there were spawners in the mushrooms. Apparently not. Or maybe they're only in some of them. Goodbye, witch. Freaking ruining my day, man. Gotcha. I kind of want to go and see what that chest is all about. Oh my gosh, there's chests everywhere, you guys. But yeah, I was really not. I was like, okay, just run for it. And that's what I did, and that was a bad idea. Indeed. Although it does look like we almost made it to where we want to be. Yeah, what is that all about, you guys? I did log out because I had to go and help my wife with something. And whenever I logged back on, that came up again. I figured it was just a short glitch, but if it's going to continuously come up, that's going to get kind of annoying. Can we do something like that? Be gone. Be gone, spider. At least they don't have jump boost. That would be terrible. Gosh dang it, guy. Well, Nova. What does that stand for, I wonder? Hide. No idea. I also can't tell if there was really anything in that chest. It looks like coal ore. Coal ore blocks? Oh! took the arrow for the creeper. That's pretty funny, actually. In fact, there are chests all around this area. Interesting. Very, very interesting. I guess we can run and try to check out that one, huh? Shall we? Shall we do that? Go for it! Run! 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 Oh, that is going to be so annoying, you guys. So very annoying. Alright, check it really quickly. Liquid starlight. Whee! Okay, run and jump and jump and run and run and jump and jump and run. There's also a bunch of gravel, which I don't think I really had paid attention to whatsoever. Oh my gosh, so many creepers, you guys. What the heck is going on, man? Alright, you gotta use the blocks and stuff, because they have to jump. They may be fast, but they still have to jump. So you can use that. I'm gonna try logging out to see if that fixes it. It's probably just a command block that's like stuck in repeat mode or something. I don't know. I'll be right back though. So when I logged back on, it was still the little message came up again. So I don't know if it's fixed or not. But nevertheless, we must move on and see what we can accomplish this episode. I know it's getting a little long. I hope to defeat this area this episode, though, if possible. Can we just do that? Ha! Go away, everybody! Of course, I knock out the torch and the guys start spawning. I just want to get to this chest, if possible. And see, this is a chest right here, isn't it? Is that a... Oh, gosh, his boots were tripping me out. Let's just go ahead and do that, and that as well, and that, and that, and I think we'll be safe. Oh my gosh, you guys, a bunch of jump boost. Okay, I need to really clean out my inventory. Let's put that stuff away. And we have a starlight sword. Oh wow, okay, yes please. I will take that. Yes, thank you very much. Yeah, those are not going to be that useful, I don't think. Can he get to me? I don't think he can actually get to me. Alright. In which case, actually, we should probably be trying to take out the spawner, huh? That would be a smart idea. Plus, it'll get me lots of levels. Alright, I think what I want to do, I think it'll help at least, is to take one of these jump potions. That's probably why I'm being given them. And I'm tempted to take a speed potion as well, but let's just avoid that for now. And leave some blocks behind so that they get a little confused. Run over here. Check it out. We got a gold pickaxe that's actually preferable to what I have right now. Gosh dang, I got withered. We're just looking for chests at this point. I know where I need to be heading. It's straight ahead, pretty much. Alright, and I will definitely take that. Lots of experience bottles in there, which I don't really need because I have the grinder. And, oop, chest. Alright, I hear you guys behind me. Oh, they're so quick, you guys, so very fast. Take out the creeper, and the skeleton, and the creeper, and the skeleton, and the creeper. Alright, let's see what's in this chest, and then I think I'm just gonna head for the exit, or whatever you want to call it, the place we're supposed to be going. We have some regen. We have... Okay, let's just go ahead and do that. And put that guy up. And what is this? Liquid starlight. I already had one of those, apparently. Let's put that up and get the regen. The gravel's making me a little nervous, but I'm okay. So far, it does not seem to be trapped in any way. And this is where we want to be heading, I think. I want to go up on top of it, maybe. Perhaps. Or not. We can just go right through the front, maybe. Right through the front? Yes, right through the front. And let's just block it off so they cannot get to me. And look, there's a spawner right here. Yes, please. I wanted to check and see if there was anything up on top of here. Put the block on the mushroom. And indeed, there is something up here, just a bunch of leather, which I don't really need at this point. I think my armor's... Oh, my armor is getting a little low there, isn't it? Alright, let's go back in. Block it back up. Alright, let's continue moving forward. I should probably refresh my torches here. We have charge creepers. Not too bad. They're just regular creepers. Or those are not... I mean, they're just creepers, so they're not too bad. But those said supernova... Which means that they're probably going to be even stronger than regular old supercharge creepers would be my guess. Can we combine these swords by any chance? Takes 10 levels. I can probably destroy the spawner and reach that. Fantastic. I want to collect that meat if I can. And we have an emergency med kit. Yeah, let's just go ahead and put up the leather as well as that. I don't think I'm going to need it. I'll take that and that. It's kind of a trade-off, speed for resistance, which you guys know my thoughts on that. I'd much rather have the speed. And refresh the torches. Oh my gosh. These guys are actually kind of fun, to be honest. They don't do very much damage, but they really do kind of throw you off and confuse you because they're going in like all which directions, but you know, they're kind of fun overall, I must say. And that seems odd, especially after we just got that other sword. I'm getting really low on blocks. In fact, I may go ahead and take these, I think. And dig out some more here. Oh, there's even more in here, actually. And more of that stuff. Okay. Let's dig out some blocks, then. Actually, before we throw away that leather, let's see about using it to repair my boots, if possible. Gonna cost 10 levels, roughly. Alright. Can't quite do it at this point. So many things, you guys. So many things. Alright, I got blocks. I have repaired my boots, and we're heading in this direction now. I threw out that glowstone. I was thinking I would just collect these, but I think I'm gonna get it back. Okay. These guys are kind of scaring me. But I do get steak from them. Which is very, very helpful. Light everything up. Okay, they don't have short fuses or anything. I just imagine that their explosions are going to be, like, super duper big. I'm also not sure if light actually affects their spawners. It should, based on what I know. And can we go ahead and pick up the little fishy guys, too? Thank you very much. With all the custom loot and stuff, you just kind of expect some of it to be used for currency. Most of the time, that's not the case, but you never know. And so it's always good to collect the things that mobs drop, especially early on in a map. Okay, I think that was just thorns. Early on in the map, whenever you're, like, looking for gear and whatnot. Oh, gosh, you guy, stop. Stop, I say. Alright, that wasn't too bad. Need to make some more torches, though. Let's go ahead and block that off. Please, no creepers spawn while I'm doing this. I hear a villager. Interesting. Don't know if that's a custom spawn or if that's just a normal skeleton. I think I shot the bat. Alright, we're good. We're safe. Kind of, maybe. Really nervous having these creepers behind me. I'm just gonna go ahead and block that off, in fact. Oh, will you stop it there, guy? Alright, I see the staircase. Lots of guys above me. Let's check and see what's in this. Oh my gosh, you guys, there's so much stuff. So much stuff to collect. I don't know where these mobs keep coming from either. I guess the spawn rate is just really high in here. Let's go ahead and put that leather up now that we don't really need it. And we have Observer's Bow. Look over there. Wait, no, look over there. Minus 100% of speed. Okay. Lots of health potions. That's nice. Eat that potato. And honestly, with how few potatoes I have, I think that the pork chops are going to be the better option here. Let's go ahead and take one of those. I keep hearing this villager, and I want to see if he has any kind of trades. Can I not access him? I guess maybe I can't access him? Oh no, there we go. Yuravan! Don't need that. Oh my gosh, you guys, that is a freaking awesome trade. Yes, please. Yes, please, I will take that. In fact, I will just exchange for some instant health, too. This is like infinite, freaking infinite health potions. This seems a little overpowered, if you ask me. Yeah, I would probably take this out. Or make the trade a bit more expensive. Alright, let's go ahead and get rid of those arrows, just so we can have lots and lots of the health potions. Let's get those on the bar. Oh, I threw out my little fishies, too. Oh well, okay. It's getting late. I need to. Let's go ahead and put up that guy as well, or just toss it out. And any more? Let's go ahead and get another one. Oh, whatever. I don't have the stuff to trade for now. Look at him. He has my potion. All right. Yes, I think we're going to take a jump boost potion. And I would love to take a speed potion, but I'm really trying to hold on to those. So let's just stick with the jump boost for now. And let's see what we can't do in here, shall we? Lots of creepers. Oh, look at that. I was going to say, we need to look under the... Okay, I just... That was pretty funny, actually. Pretty funny. Charge creepers scare me more than anything else. The rest of these guys can just go away. Don't really bother me. I would like to collect the beef, too, though. Yeah, look at all that steak, you guys. We're going to have lots of food. Lots of the foods. Take out the skeleton. Get rid of unnecessary junk. My helmet has broken at this point. Alright, I want to go and check out that hole, if possible, maybe. If possible. Alright, we have Prismarine Shard number 7. That's one thing I really haven't been looking out for here. I imagine that there are going to be more somewhere, right? But let's continue heading up to the top. And see what kind of trouble we can't get in. Okay, I see the creeper guy coming. Alright. Not a good attempt whatsoever. Oh, I see you up there, guy. Let's take you out so that you don't ruin my day. Please, stop doing that. Eat the pork chop. Regen the health. Oh, my boots are done. Really? Gosh, I just repaired them. Okay, low on the armor. And I know the video is really long at this point, too. Oh, crap, you guys. The wool is right there. I think we can do this. Do that. And go away. And that. And ender pearls. And let's just do this. Let's just get it done with, shall we? Avoid all of those guys. Gosh dang it. You serious? Are you serious? Excuse me, coming through. Oh, okay. There's another level for me to go through, apparently. That killed all of them. Lovely. Yes, indeed, there is another whole level. I thought we were... Yeah, okay. Not the case. Still got a little bit of speed. Let's regen some health, perhaps, by doing some of that, maybe? It does give me slowness, but whatever. Whatever. Let's take out the creepers so they don't cause me issues. I could just tower up from here, but I don't think I want to do that. Let's take out some of these guys, maybe. Apparently, they don't want to die. Whatever. Light it up. Grab the steak. And we are up here. Lovely. I should have blocked off that staircase. But I did not. So I guess we're just supposed to tower up now? There we go, that should work. Going up? Yes, I plan to. I think, maybe. Sneaky creeper. Very, very sneaky creeper. Alright, let's just go and exchange those. And those. And those. And those. And that. Yeah, I guess we just go, right? Let me get right in the center. I guess that's right here. And we gotta watch out for those ghasts, you guys. I don't know what's better, ladders or ender pearls. Oh, I got, like, lag spikes all of a sudden. That was weird. Alright, we should be relatively safe here. Whew. That was crazy. And we need to get all three of these, if possible. Not that. That. Okay. Now, to get out of here, let's just go ahead and do a ladder drop, shall we? Alright, and I think we'll be pretty safe getting out of here. Yes, I think so. Yep, we're going. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Okay. Didn't I just say that we're gonna be pretty safe getting out of here? I don't know if that's the case. But we're leaving. We're leaving. We are leaving. Okay. Whew. They're still coming for me, though. Wow. 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 And my armor's almost done for completely. But a good ending to this episode, I think. I'm definitely coming back here for more health potions. Whew. All right. All right, you guys. That's going to be it for me for today. Thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you enjoyed. And I will see you next time.